which is called the MOST School. And this is designed to promote evidence-informed decision-making. It brings policymakers on one hand and the researchers and scientists on the other hand together to talk to each other, to deepen their links, so that they can translate the knowledge that is produced in the universities, in research centers, into policy action, social action, and policy making.
School help us in determining the indicators of social, cultural, and environmental impacts, and to help to connect us with the government toward the government program.
People come here under the auspices of UNESCO, so you know, we get people who are real policymakers with a real interest in the work of sustainable society turning up. And they want to interface with researchers. It gives an opportunity for researchers to work together. As a school, it sounds a little bit like it's one-sided, but it's not. It's co-production. We learn, they learn, we exchange. As things, as the world becomes a more complicated place in terms of how we need to manage it and the policies that are being developed, I think the relationship between us researchers and policymakers can only get closer and can only get more and more effective.
The policymakers pay attention to our research because they make recommendations recently to initiate a program at local government level on marginalized communities.
Yeah, public policy has to have good quality public policy developed based on empirical evidence, based on the knowledge which is generated from realities in the field.
Practical applications of sustainability science, which is really what this is about. How policymakers get practical guidelines, things they can actually pick up and think about from sustainability science.
Sustainability science, by definition, is about breaking down the barriers that exist between the producers of the knowledge and the users of those knowledge.
So the application of what's called an evidence base the utilization of effective science to formulate policy is becoming more and more important.
Inilah persoalan yang selalu menjadi pikiran bagi kami, bagaimana alam yang anugerah Allah ini betul-betul bisa dimanfaatkan dengan sebaik-baiknya. Mungkin selama ini kami salah, mungkin selama ini kami keliru di dalam mengeksploitasi alam ini, sehingga manfaatnya tidak begitu banyak kami dapatkan, tetapi kerusakan alam telah terjadi di mana-mana.
Mereka juga mengajarkan kepada kami bagaimana menjadi petani yang berdasi. Petani yang memiliki wawasan yang lebih luas, tidak hanya menjadi pekerja, tetapi juga menjadi inspirasi bagi orang banyak.